Did you know that when you feel disliked, your brain literally responds as if you could die? Your brain literally perceives someone disliking you as a threat to your survival. And I have a good explanation as to why that is. The number one reason that humans have survived and thrived so well on this planet is because of our ability to cooperate. Cooperation is not just like a nice idea that we like to talk to kids about. It's something that's actually hardwired into our brain that we have compassion for other people, that we want to help and be helped, and we get serotonin and endorphin flings whenever we do cooperation. And to make this more clear, I need to give you a specific example of what I'm talking about here. Since the dawn of humanity, humans have had to live in tribes to survive. And typically, when you're in your tribe, everyone has a job, everyone has something that they do for the tribe, and everyone works together to keep everyone alive because they knew that on our own, we would not live. So if you were living in a tribe or a community, and suddenly members of your tribe or community decided that they didn't like you anymore and they started to shun you or start to push you kind of away from the health and the vitality and all of the benefits of being with everyone, if they started to push you out and, God forbid, banish you from the tribe to be alone to the elements to try to survive on your own, that was really bad for survival. So early in our human brain development, we learned that we need to be likable. We need to be a part of the group, and we are happiest in all the studies that have been done about human happiness. We still are happiest when we are connected to a loving and accepting community of some sort. And honestly, it's only like in the past 100 so years that most of modern human society doesn't necessarily live in tribes anymore. The industrial age came and made everything easily manufactured. Families became more of like a nuclear family where it was just mom and dad and the kids, and people learned to survive kind of on their own. But even though we changed the way that we live, our brains are still very much hardwired for tribal mentality, needing to be liked by everyone, and doing whatever it takes to just stay alive and be liked. But guess what, my friends? Now, if the popular girls at the lunch table, their little tribe, if they decide that they don't want you to sit with them and they shun you and they banish you, guess what? That means absolutely nothing about your survival. We are lucky enough now to have so much more autonomy as individual humans, and we can change our tribes, we can change our communities whenever we want, and being shunned or banished by one person or one group of people does not determine if we live or not. And yet, our brains will fire so many signals that's like, danger, danger, you might die. These random girls you barely know at school are banishing you from their table. You're literally dying. Oh my God. But here's what's really cool about our brains as well. We have this amazing frontal lobe right here. And the bad news is that it's not fully developed, it's not fully mature until you're 25 freaking years old. And I say that because that means you are bound to make a lot of impulsive, bad decisions. You are more likely to be run by your emotional nature before you're 25 years old. But even so, you have a frontal lobe, even if you're under 25, and that thing can help you to override and mitigate whatever weird things your lizard brain, your lower brain, whatever you want to call it, that very ancient part of your brain that wants you to survive. Your frontal lobe can help you to navigate that so that you're not operating from these weird survival like reactions that you don't actually need to be engaging that much with anymore. So here's where I start getting into some maybe hard but important truths that I want your frontal lobe to fully download and have online whenever you need the reminder. The first truth is that people are going to dislike you. That's true for you, that's true for your mom, that's true for your brother, that's true for your best friend. Every single person on this planet will be disliked at one time or another by another random human being. How do you know that's true? Well, you dislike people. You dislike people all the time. And when you dislike someone, it never feels like that threatening. You're not meaning to be mean, except for in the times that you are, which we'll get into later. But you dislike people all the time, and it doesn't really feel like a big deal to you. You're just going through your life, being discerning, picking the people that you like and the people that align with you and that you feel good with, and then you notice the people that you don't feel good with and that you don't want to spend time with, and you are discerning and choosing who you like, who you don't like. Well, guess what? Other people are doing that too, and sometimes people will choose to like you and sometimes they'll just choose not to. And often it's for really random, innocuous, unimportant attributes about you that you are disliked. It could be something as simple and random as you walked into your new work or you walked into a class wearing a coat that a random coworker or classmate doesn't like, and they just decided right there that they don't like you. And again, you know this is true because you do this to other people. Your brain is always making snap decisions about what you like and don't like. You're always categorizing people into certain themes and categories, and it's all about you. It has nothing to do with the people or the objects or whatever it is you're categorizing. It has nothing to do with them, really. The people that you choose to like or the people you choose to dislike are all a reflection of your very complex history, the things that have happened to you, the relationships, the trauma, the memories, all of the things that have made you up to this point. Those are the things that are informing you in terms of who you like and who you don't like. And everyone around you is doing the same thing. So when someone randomly chooses to not like you, it has absolutely nothing to do with you as a person. That person who has made a judgment about you is completely biased by their own inner experience that you don't know anything about. So when someone chooses to dislike you, especially when it's like a quick snap judgment where they don't even really know you, they just see you or they just heard you say one thing kind of weird and they just decided to, you know, not like you. Those really quick snap judgments of disliking someone are so, like, give no energy to those people. Most of the time you won't even know that they made that judgment about you unless they're kind of a crazy person and they decided to tell you they don't like you or one of their friends told you. Either way, if it's a snap judgment like that, someone doesn't like you, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter because you do it all the time too, and you know you're not a threat to other people because you dislike them, so it's just the same for you when other people don't like you. But now you're asking, Genevieve. And I don't know how you know my name because I never introduce myself, but my name is Genevieve. That's cool that you know that already. Genevieve, there are people that dislike me that are really mean to me though. How do I deal with that? Well, the next hard truth is that some people will be dicks. And the most important thing that you can do for yourself in any situation where someone is being mean to you or kind of lashing out at you, either passive aggressively or overtly, the most important thing that you can do for yourself is acknowledge that you absolutely cannot control that person. Because here's the thing, when someone is mean to me, I want to get back at them. I want to start the wheels churning on how I can manipulate them, suppress them, make them go away, make them stop being mean. I can even go into like people pleaser mode where I get that, again, that like deep feeling like I need them to like me. I need to figure out why they're being mean to me and I need to get them to like me. Well, my friends, that is the exact opposite of what you should be doing. Do not give an ounce of your life force, an ounce of your energy, an ounce of that thing inside of you that makes you you. Do not give an ounce of that to someone who is trying to manipulate you through meanness. Do not try to retaliate. Do not try to manipulate them. Do not try to get them to like you. Don't even think about those people. The whole point of this video is that it's normal for people to dislike you. And it's also kind of normal that in this world of so many people, some people are really hurt people and they like to try to hurt other people. It sucks that the world is this way, but those people who are the meanest, those people that are the most unkind, are usually the people that feel the most powerless and the most unloved in their own lives. That doesn't mean that you should, again, try to like make them like you or make friends with them because you feel bad for them. That just means that they have their own thing going on, their own healing to do, and you need to stay in your own lane. Even though this person's trying to get all your attention over here, you gotta stay in your own lane. Do you keep your life force and your energy to yourself and just stay focused on being yourself? And trust me, I'm a YouTuber. I've seen crazy amounts of meanness and I know that you absolutely can do that. You can ignore it. You can just bless those people in your mind and just move on with your life. You absolutely do not need to let any meanness get to you. If I can do that with my beautiful frontal lobe, you can do it. This leads me to my third hard truth that I actually think is the most important and is the whole reason I really wanted to make this video in the first place. I wanted to make this video because I have seen firsthand how broken people can be, how broken societies can be, just because of this deep, weird, lizard brain desire to desperately be liked. So many people literally lose themselves in this obsession, and it's usually a very subconscious obsession, but it's there, this obsession to be liked, to have everyone controlled and safe and responding to them the way that they think they should. So they spend all their time overthinking and planning what they're gonna say to people and always wanting to like figure out what's gonna happen next and what's this person gonna do and what do I need to do to get this person to like me. And these people have become so broken in this perceived need to have everyone like them and to have to control everyone to like them that it can drive them to serious psychological issues like anxiety and depression, even suicide. In fact, I'd say a high majority of the suicides that happen in this world are because of someone not feeling liked, not feeling accepted, and it just took over their whole brain. So if you are one of those people who either consciously or subconsciously is obsessed with needing people to like you, you're a total people pleaser, you're always over giving to people, you're always trying to be super friendly and super nice and all those things just to get people to like you, or maybe you don't even do those behaviors of being like fake extroverted and super friendly and nice, but deep down you just know that you really want to be loved and accepted, but you've shut yourself off and you're like trying to isolate because you're so afraid of your need to be liked. That's the flip side of the people pleasing. It's the same problem, but there's two, probably more than two versions of doing it. But whatever behavior you've adapted because of your fear of being disliked, you need to know this. Being liked all the time by every single person on the planet is not only impossible for you and everyone else, but it wouldn't even be good for you if it happened. That would be a lot of pressure and responsibility if literally everyone you knew was relying on you to be likable all the time. Nobody expects that of you. Just like I'm sure you don't really expect that of everyone else, and if you do, that's some other weird psychological adaptive behavior you should probably think about changing. It is not your responsibility to be likable. It is only your responsibility and your highest purpose on this planet to be your full self and to be of service to yourself and to the world in whatever capacity and gifts you've been given. And a lot of times people don't even know what gifts they have because they're so obsessed with being liked all the time and chasing whatever the Instagram pose is or the car or the thing that they think they need to have to be flashy and likable. They're so busy chasing images of success and likability that they don't even know who they really are and what their actual gifts are. This is what I mean when I say this obsessive desire to be liked is a very pervasive, corroding disease in our society, in the world. So I'm gonna give you a little tip. And this is something that I actually learned from Brené Brown that has been super helpful for me, and I'm going to tell it to you now. You don't actually need that many people in your community to be happy. Please always remember in your life that the relationships and the connections that you have with people, it's very much quality over quantity. What Brené Brown says is that you need to make a list of five people max. These five people are the people in your life that you really do have mutual care, understanding, and respect with. You both like each other, you both have communication with each other, and again, it's five people max, so it doesn't need to be five people. It could even be one or two people if you only have one or two people, but five people max who you have this mutual care with, and those are the only five people whose opinions of you actually matter to you. And anyone who's not on that list, if they have a negative image of you or an opinion about you or a judgment about you, absolutely no energy to that person or that opinion or that judgment. Earlier in this video, I said that it is scientifically proven that humans today and eons ago are happiest when we're in a very well-connected and loving community of other people, because our brains are built for cooperation and loving and giving and mutual respect. Of course, that makes sense, that we need to be with other people. We cannot be alone. We cannot just decide, F the world, I'm just gonna be an island on my own. That will never work and you will die unhappy. But what has been really misunderstood is how many people you need and how big does this community of loving people need to be. And as I said, referring to Brené Brown and from the experience of myself and lots of people, you do not actually need that many people in your life to make you feel loved and whole. Honestly, you only really need like one other person you have a really solid, good connection with to raise your happiness exponentially if you are in a place where you're not very happy and feeling alone. But ideally, I think five people is a great number. If you have five solid people in your life who you really love, you're really close with, and you have like mutual, total understanding and respect, you have a community. You have what you need. You do not need hundreds of followers on Instagram and everyone at school and everyone at work to like you. You don't need that. It wouldn't be good for you, like I said, even if you had it. And it's just not possible, not gonna happen. All you need is like five people max. So I hope all of this is really registering in this frontal lobe because we are not done. The last really important truth that I so badly want to just implant into your head right now is how important it is for you to fully accept yourself just as you are right now. Because we're obsessed with wanting to be likable, we are always nitpicking ourselves and putting into the spotlight the things about ourselves that we really don't like because we think that, well, if I don't like this thing about myself, other people must not like me too. But seriously, nobody is as hard on you as you are on yourself. And the things that you think about yourself that are super annoying or are really ugly or are really unattractive or unlikable, most people don't actually dislike you for those things. I have a personal story about this that I'm hoping will be helpful in terms of giving you an example of what I'm talking about. So first of all, I am a recovered person from the disease of needing to be liked by everyone and everything all the time. I can speak so deeply and intimately about this subject because I have been tortured by it in my youth and in my past. And one trait that I've always really disliked about myself and that I thought other people really disliked me for too is that I've always been really introverted and kind of naturally shy. I've never been the kind of person that's been like a super bubbly extroverted person. I've never been the person that's had like a ton and ton of friends. And I always felt like I needed that. I needed everyone to like me and to be bubbly. And I wanted to be just different, have a different personality. And just recently, I don't even know how this happened, some magical thing changed my brain where I realized that me being introverted and shy and kind of guarded when I'm with people I don't know is totally acceptable and a fine, normal trait for some people to have if that's their disposition. It doesn't mean I'm broken. It doesn't mean I'm unlikable. It doesn't mean I need to change and be more extroverted and put on like a false bubbly thing. I fully know and feel in myself that it's okay to be introverted, and I have no desire to change it. I have no desire to change my personality when I'm around a group of people, especially people that I don't know and maybe feel neutral about. I'm never gonna give my energy to people that I don't know if I even like them yet. I am fully empowered in myself, and I have strong connections in my life, and I just do not give energy to anyone or anything that undermines my need to just be myself all the time. I accept myself. I know what my strengths are. I know what my gifts are. I know the things that I enjoy doing, what I don't enjoy doing. And because I really authentically or genuinely know that, I attract other people who are like me and who I have a real connection with. And I'm not attracting or trying to attract people that I really don't actually have anything in common with, that I have put on a pedestal and I'm trying to like change myself and like be a little metamorphosis to get them to like me. I just don't need to do that anymore. And because I don't need to do that anymore, you don't need to do that anymore. Or if you're young and watching this video, I hope that you just don't even do it at all into your 20s. Just Just don't. The people that you don't like, be neutral towards. That's the one other thing that I wanted to add, is that you do need to be neutral or kind to people. You don't have a right to add to the suffering of someone else just because you feel like you're suffering somehow. It's okay for people to dislike you. It's okay for you to dislike them. But if you can do it in this very neutral way where you're not putting your energy towards hate, you're not thinking about them all the time, you're just like neutrally like detached from those people, that is the best way and the most normal way that you can do this whole disliking thing. Then all that energy that you're still putting out to other people is coming back to yourself, and you can actually learn who you really are, start accepting who you really are, and attract those people that are your people. Everyone on this planet has some people. That's also important to remember. There is always going to be people who dislike you, but there will also always, always be people out there who do like you. And it's for exactly who you are. It's not because you put on a show or an image of success or you do the right thing always. It's just because those people resonate with you. But it's hard for those people to find you if you're not really being yourself, or if you're putting in a lot of energy into trying to please other people and be someone you're not. Your real people can't find you if you're doing that. You truly are a miracle and a gift to this world. And I'm not calling you a miracle just to like say nice words and placate you. It's true. For you to exist on this planet exactly as you are, it's like one in a billion that you even came into existence, and the fact that you've successfully grown to this place that you've grown to at this point in your life, it's like, whoa, that's kind of rare. Like, not all humans, not all eggs and sperms get to meet up and become a person and then grow up. I mean, the people that do, they're kind of special. So you are a gift to this world, and you're very lucky to live in a time where your survival is not dependent on this limited tribe of people being around you, where you all have to help each other just to survive. Your brain might play tricks on you and say that any sort of rejection or being disliked is a threat to your survival, but now your frontal lobe knows that that's not really true anymore. But you can be understanding with that part of your brain, because for centuries and centuries that was the case. But we're lucky now to live in a time where we get to choose who we align ourselves with, and our survival is not particularly important to needing to be connected to people all the time. You're a powerful and resilient human being. You're an amazing problem solver, again, because of this frontal lobe. So if you find yourself right now in a situation where it feels like everyone is pushing you out or nobody likes you, you are incredibly adaptable to pick yourself up, transplant yourself if you need to, and find the life and the people that you want to be around that make you happy. It is okay to be disliked. It is totally normal. All of us are being disliked all the time. Oh my gosh, that's funny. But really, I think you know what I'm saying. I so hope that you enjoyed this video. I enjoyed making it. If there's something I didn't get to, which I actually feel like there's maybe a lot that I could say about this that I haven't been able to say in this video, but this video has already gotten so long. So if you have a question, or if you just want to say something about this topic, just put it in the comments below and we can have a discussion about it. If you kind of liked this video, you can always subscribe. I also have a Ko-fi account where if you really like me, you can buy me a coffee. It really helps me in this channel so much when you support me on Ko-fi. So thank you. So go out there. Don't be afraid of being disliked. And I will see you in my next video.